Well, just days after signing a proclamation designating July 13th as Nathan Bedford Forrest Day in Tennessee, Governor Bill Lee says he's now in favor of changing that state law.
Now, this state law is a decades-old statute that requires governors in the volunteer state to honor the Confederate general and early leader of the Ku Klux Klan. Governor Lee faced a lot of backlash across the state, however, and across the country, in fact, for signing the proclamation last week and for also declining to answer if he thought the law should be changed. The NAACP Memphis branch was among those organizations speaking out against the law in general and calling for change. And here with us this morning is the local executive director, Vickie Terry. Good to have you as always.
Welcome back. Good to see you.
Good morning.
The governor has now taken a step back. Are you satisfied with that, or are you disappointed that it took backlash for him to see that perhaps this was not representative of all Tennessee citizens?
Of course, we were very disturbed by this, the executive committee and our general membership. And just because he is stepping back does not mean we're stepping back. We are still going to advocate to our Tennessee legislators to make sure that this law is taken off the books.
Now, of course, there's one thing to have support from maybe the Democratic Party, but have you spoken or heard from any Republicans to say they will support this push as well?
I've heard from some Republicans. We've had people calling down to the branch, talking about how dissatisfied they were with his choice. And I think this choice was something that he made on his own. He did not have to, I don't think, enforce this law.
Now, there were some, though, who have reported that said, and he has indicated that he, because of a law, he had to sign the proclamation. What do you say about that?
Well, I don't think he had to sign the proclamation because there are a lot of laws on the books that people have not enforced. So this could have been something that he just let pass because, as I recall in the past, I don't remember this ever happening before, someone saying, I have to enforce this law.
So does it concern you that this latest move is more of a PR move? Than a true change of heart or rethinking of the situation and coming to realize?
I think it's a PR move. And the reason I say that is because he didn't say this until after all of the backlash, right, when people started calling in complaining about what he had.
But you've also said that you were quoted as saying this essentially leaves a blemish on the state of Tennessee. Why do you say that, for those who have not followed this closely?
Because of a lot of the other things that have happened in the past, as far as even us, you know, when the statues came down, mm-hmm. people complaining about that, and now this is happening because he signed on a law of a known Ku Klux Klan leader, mm-hmm. a known slave trader. These are things that I don't think should be like glorified, and this is what you're doing when you sign this law, saying this is Nathan Bedford Forrest Day.
There are those who would say that Forrest had a change of his own heart toward the end of his life, mm-hmm. and really redeemed himself in this regard, kind mm-hmm. of evolved, mm-hmm. and that we risk repeating our history if we're trying to erase history. Mm-hmm. What do you say to those folks to try to help them understand why this is hurtful, if they come from a different frame of reference? When, you know, there are a lot of folks who say, well, my family didn't yeah. have slaves, you know, my
right.
family didn't.
Right.
How do you help them?
But what you have to do, you have to think about the people that you are affecting, people of color, people of different beliefs. If you are a human being that believes in equality and human rights, mm-hmm. then this is something I think that should just be left in the past or left alone. I don't think that you need to even bring attention to certain things if you're going to, you know, move forward.
Mm-hmm. With this being, though, Vickie, 2019, what does it say, though? We are still having this conversation today. We're still having a conversation on a national basis where a president tells four women of color of Congress yeah. to go back to their home countries, essentially. What does that tell you, or what does that say to you?
Well, what we're dealing with this on several different levels. Of course, with the president being, you know, at the top, and then we got the governors that are doing the same thing. I think that a lot of them are looking at what our president says and does, and they feel like it's okay to do the same things, and that's not I don't think it's fair.
Have you reached out to the governor, or would you like for him to, or his people to reach out to the NAACP to at least further this conversation? What would be an ideal situation for
you? An ideal situation would be for them to sit down with the NAACP on a local level, a state level, and a national level.
Just as person to person,
yes,
to try to see someone else's point
exactly.
of view.
Exactly.
Is it almost better, though, that at least it's out in the conversation instead of underlying and hidden, that we are talking about it? Maybe?
I think it is. I think so. I think we need to talk more about it, because I think Governor Bill Lee needs to now prove himself that he is a unified governor instead of being divisive. And right now, it looks like he's divisive.
All right, keep us posted. We appreciate you taking the time
well,
to be with us this morning.
Thank you so much.